What's up? I'm getting over a cold. Feeling good, I'm back. I still have a little bit of the voice, you know, like the after voice, which I kinda like, I'm not gonna lie. But today's video is going to be a boxy serum unboxing. And my lips are drier than ever, good lord. I'm so barefaced, you know, I'm bald poodle today. You know, I hate looking like a bald poodle. I'm so used to having my brows on at all times that I'm just like, yeah. But today's box is actually a little bit more like skincare-y themed, so I don't have my brows on. The theme is Gift of Glam, and it's like glam skincare. Not all of it, there are two makeup items in the bag, box, and three skincare items. So the first one is the first one I'm gonna use. I have seen this brand before. Am I crazy or have we gotten something from this brand in our box? This is from a brand called Mud Masky, which something about that, I need water. Hold on. Which something about that name is so funny to me. And I feel like I've reacted that way in the past. I don't know, I'm having like a deja vu moment. But this is their mineral infused double cleansing mask, 3-in-1 formula for sensitive skin. It's supposed to deep clean, refine your pores, nourish the skin, and hydrate the skin. Basically, it's a non-foaming cleanser infused with rich minerals to detoxify and deep cleanse the face before bedtime. With skin-loving ingredients like Moroccan lava clay, fruits and flowers, makes it sustainable even for the most sensitive skin. Instructions: remove makeup, done. Two, wash your face, done. Oh, with lukewarm water. You know, I never noticed. Actually, I tend to wash my face with like freezing cold water. Apply a small amount of the cleansing mask onto your face and use soft circular motions to massage the mud until it melts into your skin. Leave the cleansing mask on your face and brush your teeth meanwhile. Okay? So if you've brushed your teeth before doing this, you're screwed. You're just gonna have to stand there. Use warm water to rinse, splash cold water on your face, and pat dry. Okay, okay. I'm just gonna get my little mirror here, and I'm just gonna like throw it on and do some circular motions right here with you guys, instead of over my sink. Let's see, it seems like it's like very liquidy, but like it's a cleansing mask, so I don't know. Okay. Okay, just feels like a cleanser, to be honest. Like a face wash and a moisturizer. Yeah. More moisturizer now, actually. Like a moisturizer with a little bit of a face wash vibe in there as well. So I'm just gonna rub that everywhere. And then I'm gonna go brush my teeth, wash my face, and I will be right back and let you know. This says it replaces your nightly cleanser, so you could use it every evening. My face is smoother than a baby's bottom. I always think of the little rascals. He's smoother than a baby's bottom. And he smells better too. I can recite that entire movie, like right now. Word for word, from beginning to end. I remember watching that movie when I was a kid and being like, I want a love like that. I want a boy to put a ring inside of a little crunchy round ice thing. I want that. But no boys were ever like alfalfa, unfortunately. My face does feel really, really nice, really soft. It's definitely right. It is very non-foaming. It was so weird when I was like rinsing it off because it felt like there was nothing on my face since it didn't get soapy or sudsy. But I actually really like that because I didn't feel like it dried out my skin. My skin feels really, really fresh and soft and not tight or anything, so I like that. Yeah, I mean, I will continue to use the Mud Masky and we'll see. Anyway, before I throw on some makeup, we've got some more skincare to test out. We have this lip mask from the brand Wish, not like the Wish website, different. This is their vanilla bean lip mask with buka, with, no, baku, not buka, with bakuchi oil. If I had to pronounce that the way I think it's pronounced, bakucho, bakuchi oil. And this is their intense overnight hydration mask. It softens, it smooths, paraffin free, sulfate free. Super cute packaging. I'm actually gonna throw this on right now, even though it's an overnight mask, because my lips are so dry. So I'm just gonna tell you, like, the back of my nail and do a little scoop. Smells yummy. It almost smells like pineapple vanilla. Am I nuts? I smell pineapple in this. It smells really good though. Doesn't taste the best, but smells quite lovely. It says naturally sourced ingredients, tested on us, not on animals. I love that. And yeah, I'm gonna throw some more on right before bed. And hopefully it does the trick.
And then the other skincare product is from the brand Alginist, right?
Oh my gosh,
how did I graduate? But I was really excited when I saw this in the box because this is a pretty pricey brand. So like,
that's expensive. How much is this?
Yeah, $68.
Damn.
This is their Triple Algae Eye Renewal Balm and it reduces the look of dark circles.
Yes, please.
And it's got like multi-peptide complex, you know, all those fancy like, you know, science-y words
that make me go, ooh.
But basically it's a targeted eye treatment with enhanced algae technology, clinically shown to help reduce dark under eye circles, bags, puffiness, lines, wrinkles, and crow's feet.
The thought of it helping my wrinkles?
Yes, please. Please. I love getting pricey skincare in these boxes, I swear. I will most likely splurge on like an expensive makeup item, I think. Well, maybe not. I don't know. What do you guys think? If you had to splurge, like, okay, I'm really, really gonna splurge. This is very pricey, but I'm gonna take the plunge. Is it going to be a skincare item for you or is it going to be a makeup item? I'm very curious to know. Leave me a comment down below. But okay, anyway, I'm going to throw on some makeup really quick and I will be right back to test out the last two products. Okay, I'm back.
And my brows are on.
Okay, we have two more products in the box. And I'm very nervous because it's getting very late. And I gotta put some eyeliner on. And you guys know, I'm really skilled, really good at eyeliner. So this is the Luna Liner Water Resistant Liquid Eyeliner. And I'm curious to see what color it is.
Do you think it's black? Do you think it's a color? I haven't checked. Black.
Let's test out this bad boy. This water resistant bad boy. It's gonna be so fun removing this in 5 minutes. Okay, so hear me out. It's almost impossible for me to do it on camera because I have to get so close to my mirror in order for them to look like even this much the same. So I'm sorry about that, but I tried to get them as even as possible. And I think I like this. At first when I was starting to use it, I was like, oh, I don't know if I like this because it is more of a drier formula. Like, I don't know how to explain it. When you're swatching it, like you can see it's, well, I mean, that was pretty intense, but I don't know. It has more of a drier, less messy kind of application. Like, you know how some liquid liners are just like so liquidy that you put it down and it's like, it's so much, you have to be very, very careful. I feel like this, because it's not too liquidy, it's not like soaking the felt tip, like it's a little bit drier, I felt like it was easier to use. I don't know, it was like more foolproof. The only thing is like, is it gonna dry up a lot faster because it's already a drier formula? I don't know how many uses I can get out of this, but I kind of liked how easy it was to use, and it's super black. Like it's really, really black, really matte. It doesn't have a shiny finish at all.
I really like it.
I can see how some people might not like it because of that drier formula, but for me, I felt like it was easier to use. I don't know. I was pleasantly surprised, I gotta say. Okay, and then to complete this look, we have a highlight. And this is actually a really nice highlight because on my skin tone, it's more of a blush topper, but I feel like it is a more universal shade. So if you have like very, very fair skin, you can use it as a blush topper, or if you have like much deeper skin, you can use it as a highlight. This is the Sophia and Maybelle Satin Powder Highlighter. And this is in the shade Peach Sangria. And honestly, I thought it was gonna be like light and peachy, but when I was opening it earlier, it is a little bit more of like a peachy bronze shade, which would be a really, really stunning blush topper, like I mentioned. So let's see. I already have a little bit of my Pat McGrath Desert Orchid blush, just like a little bit, like I'm barely there. And now I'm gonna take my Lip Tool ColourPop brush and dip it into some Peach Sangria. Tu sabes. Oh my gosh, that is stunning. Probably getting a little too intense there. Definitely a blush topper on me. But if you have a deeper skin tone, it would be a gorgeous highlight. But it does make the cheek look so glowy though. Okay, so this is what it looks like on my face. I really, really like that. It gives like a really nice bronzy warmth to the skin. I did add a little bit too much on this side, but this side looks a little better. I like the overall glow it gave my cheek though. So pretty. But okay guys, that's it. I really enjoyed this month's box. Love my cheeks. Love that eyeliner. Love that we got an Algenis product. And yeah, I mean, I like everything I tried. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below letting me know what you got in your box this month. Did we get the same things? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Let me know in the comments below. But that completes this video, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so, so, so much. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Refine your pores. Restore-ish. No. Restore your skin. Restore-ish. Wow.
What if we rewrite the stars that you were meant to be mine?
I still have a little bit of the voice, you know, like the after voice, which I kind of like, I'm not gonna lie.
How now, brown cow?